vindication because my true fans have always been here for me.
When you really can reach your fans and be here to actually meet them in person, that's the most validation I could ever have. It's not about charts and all that stuff. Of course, I'm grateful to have my biggest single of all time this year. It's amazing, but this is what it's really about.
I'm grateful to be able to have, you know, overcome obstacles. To be able to get here, it's like, I just want my kids, you know, to feel like they can be proud of me. You know, now that I have kids, it's a different ball game. Like, I feel like maybe I helped clear the way, if for nobody, but, you know, for them, so they don't have to feel like restrained or like they're so different from the rest of the world or they're so held down, you know, like just to break through some of that.
Now you have the record for most number one singles by a solo artist. The all-time record is 20.
The Beatles, yes.
Beatles.
Yes, and we're not even trying to go near them.
Are you gunning for them? Well, yeah,
they're the Beatles. I mean, they're technically not, it can't be.
But the odds are they're not going to get back together
to
beat you. I mean, that seems unlikely. You could really smoke them and leave them in the dust. Is that your secret wish, to beat the Beatles?
Absolutely not, no.
It is not?
No.
I have books from my fans here. These helped me out in a time when I wasn't feeling quite so very happy. The originality of my fans is unparalleled. They make me happy. So we dedicate the Butterfly Room to them. They can come sleep over here.
I just want to say thank you for allowing me to live my dream and to make music and to be here with you experiencing it.
So, having a moment.
So the tweet versation, let me just read this. Kelly said, okay, tomorrow I'm performing at Idol in front of Mariah Carey. Pray for me. Hashtag, please, dear God, don't let me suck.
And my response
come on, Kelly, you're always hashtag pow. I can't wait to see you. You're so talented. So did she pass the test?
Please,
you have to say yes now.
She sung some more of my songs than I've sung, and I'm like, darling.
Oh my God, I love you.
I'm like, I need your opinion on some
just let
stuff.
You guys die. Yeah, you guys.
You introduced me to her.
I introduced you at a radio show.
I'm so glad you're not mean.
We
heard the numbers, but what most people don't get the opportunity to experience is the true woman, the mother. The virtuous person, my angel, someone in when times are hard, she's there. You guys don't see her at 3 o'clock in the morning, getting up in the middle of the night, fixing me soup and stuff when my kidneys ain't acting right. And Mariah Carey does that.
I've just watched Ken over the years, like even when I first did the first Divas Live, it was for in honor of Aretha Franklin, the Queen of Soul. Yes, Aretha Franklin. And I just saw him not turn down the air conditioning for Miss Franklin, and I just said, I don't know about that. If she says turn down the air conditioning, that air conditioning needs to go down.
What?
So she wrote me this letter, and she has flown 23, no, she drove in a car 23 hours to see me. And she didn't even have tickets to go to the show. So I haven't met her yet. We're gonna go find her, give her these pictures, and also these tickets.
Yes! Look, I have your letter. Thank you.
Aww.
And we see you tomorrow. Oh, look, she's got the charm bracelet album. This is my friend's favorite album. That's it. That one? I'm gonna do this.
Kelly makes fun of myself every time I go, darling, da 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 da. We know I'm acting like a fake diva.
It sounds fake.
Exactly. But, you know, some people take it seriously.
Having somebody come up to you and say, you helped me get through the toughest period of my life. You helped me get through something I thought I may not make it out the other side of. That's probably the greatest reward as an artist for me.